Hello, it's Jang here with a look at the Mega Bloks Halo Scorpion Sting set. This comes with 616 pieces. This is based on the Scorpion variant from Halo 5, which, as of the time of the recording of this video, has not yet been unveiled to the world. So this is kind of the first unveiling of the look of the updated Halo 5 Scorpion. Because we don't have official pictures, I can't say or I can't speak to how accurate this toy is, this model is. But I can say that it looks pretty cool, and the build was quite nice. The build was much, much, much better than the old Scorpions, by far. The biggest deal here is that the track cowlings, if you will, are completely built up. You actually have to put those together. And they make some interesting uses of parts. Like you can see that the width here is not exactly four studs, it's 4.5. So they actually did a little bit of odd building there, and it works. It works out pretty well. It didn't add too much bulk to the whole thing. As a matter of fact, I think it may have added good bulk, and they did that for all four tracks. Still have the same old four track setup. These are articulated, but they're limited a little bit, so this won't go up too far. There's a stopper right there that'll keep it from going too far. It can go down quite a bit though, but I appreciate that little bit of stopping in there. Also, they have some friction in here, so these won't just drop. Like you can see that right now, the front one isn't just dropping like the old ones used to kind of flop around, especially on that very first one. But the level of detailing here is pretty good. When you go up to the turret section, a lot of different styling. It looks like they kind of have the upgraded style with the double canisters there. This is an interesting piece right here at the tip of the main barrel. It's not just a regular cylinder piece, not a 1x1 cylinder piece. It's actually a little bit of a different design that has an anti-stud on both sides, and it will actually accommodate an axle in the center of it. I had not seen that part before myself. This can go up, and there's a lot of friction in there, and it can go down. That helps it to be smooth. It actually can't go down quite as far as you would like because of this smaller turret in the front, but we'll look at that in a second. And then you've got the smaller caliber weapon here, which can also go up and down. Nicely integrated, simple there. Of course, the turret can be rotated around full 360 degrees. Not much friction to be had in there, but it's enough. And yeah, different kind of shaping, very asymmetrical, and again, pretty nice build. You know, the actual process of putting it together felt good. At the back here, you have a storage compartment, so you could put whatever you want in there. If you want, you could stuff a figure or two, maybe even three or four if you really flatten them out if you want, but I think it would make more sense to put supplies in there or weapons or things, but they had the space, so they made it available that we could actually use. At the front, the point defense anti-infantry machine gun has its little turret here, which will accommodate a Spartan who can actually go all the way down in there, and that's just as far down as he will go. So this is my least favorite thing on the set, although I completely understand it. This just sticks up so far, this barrel section, but that's because of the size of the Spartan figures, and the Scorpion itself is not really to scale, truly to scale with the figures, so a figure who's standing in it is not going to look right, and as a result they needed to have enough room to hold them. They needed to be able to spin the whole thing around with the character, so you end up with all this space up above. I think they could have kind of artificially built this up a little bit around the edges, just a little bit more, just behind this silver stripe to help kind of hide that a little bit more. Wouldn't have been as accurate all of the shaping, but you know, I think they did the best that they could with what they had. The main actual pilot position is in here, and you kind of need to move the turret out of the way. Driver's position, I should say. Just has a single seat in there that will accommodate any size of normal figure. And when this comes down, it's a windscreen piece that is completely opaque. So that is appropriate. Comparing the three generations of Scorpions against each other, you can see that the new one is the most bulky. It's the widest, but it also has the largest turret section that's built up the most. But overall, the proportions are similar, except for the size of the turret. The proportions of the bases are similar, even though the new one has the built-up whole track sections. And that's because they've got one stud width or one brick width to the outside and one to the inside for each of these that are holding them in, whereas the old setup just had two studs, or the width of a two-wide brick, to the inside, and then the tracks were more exposed towards the outside. So it all kind of works out, even though there's a lot more building involved here, because this is just all one piece with just a few little pieces put up on top. And over here, this actually had a little bit more building with the older version, with a little bit of extension towards the rear. Another thing that I didn't mention that's a big improvement with the new one is that this smaller caliber gun barrel in here is fairly secure, in addition to being able to go up and down to elevate. Whereas the other ones, not only could they not elevate, but they would break off very easily just by virtue of how they were attached. Also, the new one doesn't get the antennae, which were also liable to fall off very easily. And like I mentioned with the treads, the old treads, I forgot that the Covert Ops one had that same problem. I thought it was mostly the first one, but yeah, those treads would just fall. Whereas with the new one, it just feels better this way, just having the friction pin rather than using the full loose ones. Better look from around the other side. Another thing that's improved in terms of the level of friction and just how well it holds is the turret itself, because these were fairly free flowing around and they would just, you know, the slightest little incline in the hull itself would cause the barrel just to fall towards the direction of gravity. Whereas with this new one, there's just a little bit of friction in there that, again, just makes it work better and hold its position. For figures, left to right, we get an official Spartan buck. In the center is a protector Spartan, and on the right is just a generic Storm Elite Miner in a dark blue color. 343 kind of did a cheesy thing with the armor for buck. They tried to tie it to ODST, the look of an ODST armor set, a lot. They even call it the Helljumper variant. Which, you know, it's kind of like they were saying, hey guys, let's call it Helljumper. The fans will get it. Because get it? It's ODST. The ODSTs call themselves Helljumpers. And that Buck was an ODST. Yes, 343, we get it. Buck was an ODST. He was in ODST. You don't have to keep reminding us. We know that. But anyway, as a figure here, as a toy, I think it looks pretty good, and I especially like that color. I like that color quite a lot. It is a just slightly greenish, dark medium gray. They just kind of mixed together a little bit of green in with a gray. It's the least saturated green that we've gotten to date, I think. And the level of detail in the main body armor piece, I think, is pretty good. He comes with just another regular assault rifle. The Protector Spartan has an oversized SMG. That's an old SMG from like 2009. How that got into a set in 2015, I don't know. It's not supposed to be in this set. I'm quite certain of that. It doesn't scale to these figures at all. It was designed for a different scale of figure at a different time. I don't think it was even designed for the Halo figures. It was for stuff before that. But on the box, they show you just the regular smaller size. So I think this was just a mistake. And then your Storm Elite over on the right just has a Storm Rifle, you know, because, it's just fitting, yeah. The very last thing included in the set is this little plasma turret, a cute little plasma turret for your Elite to operate and to get blown up with. But in all seriousness, you can never have too many of these as just extras to just sprinkle about the battlefield. They make for good, you know, extra population of enemy weapons that are common in the games. And yeah, I think they look pretty good and they work out pretty well as just small little add-ons to any scene. So the big story, I think, with this set is improvement. I believe it has a number of objective improvements over the old versions, with here having the prints and the friction joints and better durability, better use of space, and also more of it actually being built by you, the owner. Of course, there are plenty of subjective factors that could go either way, and that's going to depend upon each individual person's viewpoint, you know, what you think of how it looks and its proportions. And of course, we need to wait to see what this thing is actually going to look like in game before we can really judge just how well Megablocks has rendered it in brick-built form. The big cylinder for the machine gun turret, I think, really stands out in a bad way here, but that's the only major thing that I can take away from the look of this set. But obviously it's important for the play value and to interact with the figures. And design-wise, they could not have put that any lower using that same piece. It's all the way down on the floor. Good to get another official named character. Certainly Buck is one that people are gonna like. Well, I'm sure people already like before even seeing his new version or playing as his new version in game or beside his new version in game. The other figures I think are fine, although I really wish I had not gotten the ancient version of the SMG. Overall though, I'm definitely happy with this set. Let me know what you think about this set by leaving your thoughts in a comment down below after you check out the video description, which has answers to all of the most frequently asked viewer questions. Thank you for watching, thanks in advance for your feedback, and I'll talk to you again very soon.